Hare Krishna. Sometimes when we start practicing spiritual life and we understand that I am not the body, that I am the soul, then we may start neglecting our body and its genuine needs. We may not eat enough, we may not sleep enough, and we may start tormenting our body like that. And if somebody very carefully attends to their body's needs, we may start thinking that that person is in bodily consciousness. The person is not at all spiritually conscious or Krishna conscious. It's not necessarily like that. Actually, the body is our vehicle for functioning in the world, even for serving Krishna, and it is essential and it is an indispensable and an irreplaceable vehicle. We absolutely need it and we won't get any other replacement for it if it gets damaged. So, this is the vehicle which we need, this is the vehicle we have to work with. So, therefore, taking care of the body's needs is vital so that the body can help us to serve Krishna. Suppose we have a vehicle and that is the only vehicle we have to get to a very important program. Then, making sure that the vehicle is fueled properly, oiled properly, and it is properly functional is vital. And that is a part of the package that we need to take care of so that we can get to the program. Similarly, for serving Krishna, our body is an essential vehicle. And if we don't take care of the body's needs, then if the body crumbles, then we will not be able to serve Krishna at all. So, if somebody just focuses on taking care of the car so much, that they don't go for the program only. So, taking care of the car will take my whole day, therefore I can't go for any program. That is foolishness. Similarly, if we let our whole life be consumed by taking care of the body's needs, then that is definitely a problem. We need to make sure that we also do other things constructively, that we whatever time is needed for our particular bodily vehicle, so that we attend to it, we do that. But having done that, we move forwards and we serve Krishna with all the remaining time and energy and facility that we have. So if we see the body as a vehicle for serving Krishna, then being conscious of the body's needs can also be a part of being Krishna conscious. In fact, the Bhagavad-Gita says that when we learn to take care of the body's needs in a proper way, then our practice of yoga can take us towards transcendence. Yuktahara viharasya yukta cheshtasya karmasu yukta swapnava bodhasya yogo bhavati dukkha. That when we are regulated in our eating, sleeping, work, recreation, then the body will not come in the way of our spiritual realization. Then our spiritual practice will lead us yogo bhavati dukkha. It will free us from distress. So, by being conscious of the body as a vehicle for being conscious of Krishna, we can use the body constructively and fulfill our life's spiritual purpose. Thank you. Hare Krishna.